So in the previous video, we talked about how we can use TorchMetrics to make the computation of metrics, such as the accuracy, more convenient during training. Now let's do the same thing and modify our code to compute the accuracy for our test set. So here you see a code file we used before. However, we will make two small modifications. So we have before, we have this train step and we have the validation step. We are also using this shared step here to make things a little bit more organized. So in shared step, what we specify is all the code that we use in the training step, in the validation step, and then also in the test step we are going to use. So instead of redefining the whole code, we are using this method shared step that we define once here. And this will return the loss, the true labels, and the predicted labels. So we're just refactoring our code a little bit so that we can reuse these lines without retyping them. Now, the new part that I'm going to add here is the test step. So we have the interesting part, the test step, which will of course also make use of the shared step method. However, the difference is really very tiny compared to the validation step. It's that we are logging the accuracy. I can also call it just test accuracy here. Doesn't really matter that we are logging the test accuracy here compared to the validation set accuracy and by default. So this is only executed in Lightning after training. And so note that validation step is executed by Lightning during training, while test step is a method that is not executed during training. So in order to access the test set accuracy, we will have to add a little bit more code here. So we will have to add a new line, the test accuracy here. And for that, we use the test method of the trainer on the test data loader. And then this is returning a dictionary structure. So we are indexing into this dictionary to obtain the accuracy value that we want to obtain. Now we can do the same thing then also for training and validation, just to have it there for reference. So we can compare our training accuracy, validation set accuracy, and test accuracy side by side. So we can also use the test method here, just swapping the data loaders. Now one thing is missing, of course. We want to, of course, print out these values. Otherwise, we're not going to see them when we execute the script. So let's hit play here and run this code. As you can see, the validation accuracy and training accuracy are shown during training. The test accuracy is not, because it's not computed during training. Yeah, and then when the training has finished, we can take a look at the training accuracy here, the validation set accuracy, and the test accuracy. And this looks all good to me. So in this video, we also now covered how we can use TorchMetrics for the test set. However, you may have noticed when you run deep learning code that you sometimes get different results. This is due to randomness, and in the upcoming lecture, we will discuss the different sources of randomness in more detail.